Hello YouTube's Grossama, and here we have today is the High Gray Bill Divers GBN Base Gundam. Appearing only in episode 25 of Gundam Build Divers, this mobile suit is essentially a heavily modified guard frame, so a lot of the inner frame parts are going to be borrowed from the guard frame high grade, but a lot of this is actually going to be very, very brand new, most of the outer armor especially. So I know one of the biggest gripes about this kit is going to be the colors. The one thing I will say is, yes, the yellow is very ugly. That highlighter yellow just absolutely has to go. But subtract that, if it was just more of a normal yellow and all the other colors were exactly the same, I think this kit would look pretty damn good. But ultimately, this is not the same color as it was shown in the anime. It was very flat colors. So I would really kind of urge you to go ahead and paint it if you can. So when looking at the details, the head sculpt is phenomenal. I think this is possibly the best looking head sculpt of an RX-78-2 I've ever seen. And I've built quite a few. I've built them all the way from the origin line. I built them from the original. I built some of the 1.0, 2.0, 1.5. And I'm so much in love with this particular sculpt. So there should be stickers that are used for the eyes. There's actually two stickers for the eyes. Then there are stickers for the top camera in the front and in the back. However, I just went ahead and painted that. And then there also is some paint that is in the side vents, the Vulcans, and just some panel lining going around the faceplate as well as the side of the head. Now the details on the body are somewhat non-existent because there's really no panel lines except for a little bit on the side of the body, and that's pretty much all you're gonna get. It does allow you to go ahead and scribe some panels in there, so if you really want to go ahead and test out your skill sets, maybe go ahead and try and do some scribing. So the arms for the most part aren't really bad at all. The biggest problem is going to be that giant seam line in the middle of the forearm. So that's actually very reminiscent to the Jim Jim, which was from the GM's Counterattack. If you can, you know, definitely go ahead and do a seam line removal, but yeah, that's just a very big eyesore. And they also have peg holes in the back of the arm, so that way you can plug in many accessories, much like the shield, and anything else that is compatible. And moving right along to the backpack, you're gonna have these two giant peg holes. A little bit of an eyesore, but you know, allows you to plug in any kind of accessories, and they really do advertise, you know, those little angel wings from the Build Custom set. But other than that, it's a pretty normal looking backpack, nothing really too spectacular. And the waist is very much reminiscent of the RX-78-2, but there's no V right there on the crotch piece, so if you really want to keep it kind of more canon to an RX-78, for whatever reason, you're going to have to go ahead and make your own little V right there on the crotch. And on the back skirt, you're going to have that little peg hole once again, so if you want to plug in any kind of accessories, you're definitely going to be able to. And when looking at the legs, they're very athletic looking. So in the upper calf and the thigh, it's gonna be very meaty. But when it comes to the, you know, more of the feet and then the ankles, a little bit more slender, and that's where it kind of has that more agile look. Definitely like it. I don't know, just something about the legs. I think they look super awesome. And when we get into poses, you're definitely gonna be impressed. So when taking a look at the articulation, this kit is going to be nothing short of amazing. I absolutely love every aspect about posing this kit. I've probably just built the kit to essentially pose it. I love the aesthetics, I love the looks, but man, those poses is just the key to my overall enjoyment of Gunpla, and this kit is just nailing it. So ultimately, when you're posing this kit, I mean, you're really gonna have a tough time for the fact that you're gonna wanna put it in so many different poses, you're not gonna be able to really choose one because you're gonna probably put it on your shelf and then ultimately take it down and then readjust it, which is actually really awesome. Now moving on to accessories, the only hands it's gonna come with are going to be these open hands. So not really too bad, they're good for accessories, but when gripping the pistols, I'll show you. So the first one we're gonna take a look at is going to be the beam rifle. Ultimately, the beam rifle does not look too bad at all, but it could have definitely been improved on. I think it's really just missing a proper handle at the bottom and maybe just a little bit more detail. But other than that, it's not really the worst beam rifle I've ever seen. So yeah, I would definitely accept it. And also, unfortunately, the hands don't have trigger fingers. So that's gonna look a little weird. And it's gonna come with another beam rifle. So you can definitely go desperado and any mobile suits that's gonna be coming your way. And it's also going to come with these pistols that originally came with the guard frame. And you can also enhance the look of the poses with the build hands edge. So if you are definitely into, you know, maybe just getting some different types of poses in, utilizing these will definitely be beneficial. And the pistols also have this little attachment, which I can only assume enhances the firepower of the pistols. You also get this nice, beautifully crafted shield that is just going to attach on the underside of the forearm. So the last weapon I want to talk about will be the beam sabers. You do get two beam hilts, you get the beam effect parts, and that's it. So nothing really too noticeable about these that are different from your kind of basic beam sabers. But other than that, they do look pretty damn good. And so for comparisons, here it is next to the 00 Sky. And next to the Master Grade Unicorn Gundam. And before I go into my final thoughts, I'm just going to show you the UV light. So you can see it's pretty reactive on mostly the yellow as well as the red, but you know, everything else is fairly normal. So for my final thoughts, well, going to the positives, this kit is highly poseable. It's fantastic to look at, so the aesthetics is just through the roof. The amount of accessories that you do get with the, you know, multiple different beam rifles and beam pistols, that's great. I just really love that. You get the shield, you get the beam sabers, you get the beam, you know, saber parts and all that. So that's all really good. The only big problem I would say is definitely going to be the lack of hands. You're only going to get the one set of hands, so you're not going to get the trigger finger or any of the other type of hands that come with the custom set. So if you really want to, you know, maximize the poseability and just dynamic of this mobile suit, you're really going to have to buy that extra handset. Otherwise, I think this kit is just, you know, just superb, complete superb. So if you are looking for this kit, it's going to be relatively cheap. I think it's going to be around the same price as the guard frame. And that's, I don't know, that's a pretty damn good price, coming around like, what, $15 to $17? So definitely do yourself a favor. I would say look into this if you can. Pick it up. And if you do not like the yellow color or any of the colors in this mobile suit, you definitely have the opportunity to go ahead and paint it. So flat colors, I've already seen a couple builders do it already. It looks super good with flat colors. So I definitely recommend you to go out, maybe grab some paint, maybe get a little scriber, scribe some details into it, and bam, make your own little RX-78-2. But other than that, guys, that's it for me. I definitely appreciate all y'all for watching, and I'll be seeing y'all in the next review. Bye-bye.